Hi, I'm Isaac from SEL. In this video, I'd like to show you how to configure the EtherCat network for an SEL-2240 Axion. In this system I have here, I have a 10-slot backplane with a 2241 RTAC, a power coupler, and 8 digital input modules. I also have, as a second node, a 4-slot backplane with 1 power coupler and 3 digital output modules. In between these nodes, I have an EtherCat connection between port 1 on this power coupler and port 1 on this power coupler to provide EtherCat communications between the nodes. So I'm going to show you how to configure this EtherCat network using Accelerator RTAC software. The first thing I want to do is create a new Axion project. To do that, I will navigate to the new SEL RTAC project right here and click on that. And the dialog that pops up here gives me a few different options. For the RTAC type, I want to select RTAC Axion, and then I'm using R133 for this project, so that's already selected. That should be good to go. Make sure you pick the correct firmware for your system. I will also give my project a custom name, My Axion Project, and then click Create. Okay, so now that our RTAC project is open, the first device I'm going to add is my power coupler for node 1. I can do that by right-clicking on Devices and going to Fieldbus I/O and SEL, or I can go to the Insert tab and go to Fieldbus I/O. Navigate to SEL and go to the power coupler. In this case, I'm using a copper 125-volt power coupler, so I'm going to select that one. I will give it a specific name that helps me organize my devices and my two different nodes. So I'm going to call it PC for power coupler. I will add the name node 1 because this power coupler is in node 1. And I will also add the letter B because this module is in slot B. Then I will click insert. So the next step I want to do is add my 8 digital input modules. I can do that by going to the insert tab, Fieldbus I/O, and navigating to the 24DI module. In this case, I'm using the 125-volt modules. I'll select that one. I'm going to choose a name that helps me organize my modules in the different nodes. So I'll call this DI underscore node 1 underscore C. This digital input module is in slot C. And click Insert. Now that I've added my first digital input module, I can easily create 7 more by clicking on it, going to the Home tab, clicking on Copy, and then clicking Paste. This window will pop up and it will allow me to create multiple modules at the same time that are copies of the original. So if I click on this Add button down below and select the amount that I want to add, I'll put in 6 because there's already one here available. And click Add. Now I have 7 more modules here that I can add into the project. And I want to give each of these a special name that'll help me keep them organized. So this one goes in slot D, so I'll just change it to slot D. And I'll change all the names to coordinate with the slots that the modules are in. Once I'm finished naming all the modules, I'll click Paste. And they should all pop up in the project tree over here. Now what's cool about this is when I copy and paste it in this way, it'll copy all the settings and everything. It won't just copy the module itself, but it'll also copy all the settings that you configure for this module. The next step is to add all our devices for node 2. I can right-click on this, select Copy, right-click on it again, and select Paste, and I can create another power coupler for node 2. In this case, I want to call it PC underscore node 2, and this one will be in slot A. I'll select Paste, and that should show up over here. So I have 3 more modules to add. I'm going to go to the Insert tab, select on Fieldbus I/O once again, and go to 16DO module. In this case, I'm using a Form A DO module. So I'll select that one. I'll give it the name that I prefer. It's node 2, and this one will be in slot B. Then I will insert that. And one more time, I will copy these by right-clicking on it and selecting Copy, and then right-click on it again and select Paste. I have 3 of them, so I want to add 2 more. So I'll add 1 more to this panel here and give them each a name that follows my convention. So this one is in slot C, and this one is in slot D. So now that we have all our modules added to our project, the next step is to add all these modules into our EtherCat network. So all I have to do that is navigate to the EtherCat IO network right here, select on connections over here, and then go to slot A. So to start off, I'll just add all my modules for node 1. I can do that by right-clicking on this and select Attach Devices. Now a panel will show up that shows all your devices that you can add to your EtherCat network. In this case, I want to add all the ones that go with node 1. So I'll select all, then I'm going to deselect all my node 2 devices and click Attach. It'll automatically add all my modules to the slots for this node. You'll notice that all of these modules showed up in the correct order in the correct slots. You'll want to double check this when you add your modules. One tip for you is that when you're adding your devices, once you get to this point, if you've added them in the order of A to J, all of them will automatically show up in the right order when you add them into the node. Okay, so now that we've added all our devices for node 1, I need to add another node for my 4-slot backplane. To do that, I can right-click anywhere in here and click on Add Node. In this case, I'm using a 4-slot backplane, so I'll click on that, and I'm starting in slot A. And I'm just going to keep the name node 2. And to add modules to this node, we do the same thing we did before. Just right-click on this field here and click Attach Devices. And I'll select all, because all these devices are in node 2, and click on Attach. Okay, the last thing we need to do is connect these two nodes together. To do that, select on port 1 up here, and connect that to port 1 on node 2. This is the EtherCat connection between the two nodes. Once all my devices are in there, I can hit Control S to save it, and we should be good to go online. So once your project has been downloaded to your Axion, your EtherCat network should be set up and ready to go. Thanks for watching this video. Please stay tuned for our other videos if you want to learn more about the Axion system.